All right. So you may know, about maybe 3 days ago, I ran into Michael. And we kind of hung out, found some really cool camping spots. As you can see, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful camping spots. I had a chance to take a shower, get my laundry done, re-up the bag, fill up the water tanks, totally refresh. So he picked me up around Florence, and we drove down to California into the Redwoods. So basically what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna head back north, up back to Florence. So basically doing the second half of the state northbound. Right now I'm here in Crescent City. Michael just dropped me off over here at the park. And I got the phone tucked over here in the rocks. Try to keep it out of the wind so you can hear me. I'm over here by a lighthouse and a jetty. Sign on the jetty says not safe to walk on, so I walked on it for a little bit, but I didn't go out to the rocks. It starts to get windier and windier as you go out, but I'm over here by a lighthouse that I want to show you. It's just as soon as I get done yapping. And after that I'll show you the scenery around here from on top of this rock. And then I'm gonna explore the town a little bit more and then walk on north. But check this out, let's climb this rock. I warn you, it will be a little loud with the wind. So I guess at high tide, you can drive up to the, or at low tide, you can drive up to the lighthouse. If you had a vehicle, then navigate those rocks. Crescent City, California. Stopped here on the trail, found a spot with no wind, so I can talk. Well, there may be a little wind. It's a trail going up that rock, probably not gonna take it. Nice place to stop. Yeah, I'm still right in the middle of Crescent City. Crawl up this thing. Head north up its coastline. See what we can find. Pretty soon I'm gonna have to stop for lunch. That'll be fun. Right, moving on. I'm getting back out here into the wind again. Getting pretty windy out here. It's whipping up pretty good. Came down here because I saw this little rock cliff here that's blocking it. It's coming up off the ocean and it's pretty strong. Now the choppy seas are just absolutely gorgeous, but the wind is a drag. I don't know what kind of camping situation we're gonna get into later. Might be real awesome, it might suck. Alright, I walked up to a homeless camp, so let's go see what it looks like. Yeah, let's go see. Dresser, chair, chairs are good to have, shopping cart, very low clearance in here, baby stroller, beer cans, another baby stroller. Very overgrown back here. Oh Lord. Baby toys. Kind of awful back here. VCR. Bike helmet, fan, cooking pot, rain gear. Blankets, like pee bottles back there. Blender. Some old movie reels. So maybe that was a projector. A garage door opener. Massive amounts of garbage. Basically, all this is a vacuum cleaner. Could have cleaned this place up, they had that. Thing. Mic drop. Crap in my shoes. Oh, there's the perpetrator right there. Elmo. What are you doing out here, man? What happened? Oh, no. Elmo. Elmo's completely out of it right now. We're gonna let him be. Elmo, get some help, brother. All right, I've had enough of this one. Get back on the road and keep walking. Wow. Oh, a toilet. there's a path that way, but very overgrown. Yeah, I'm gonna go and step out. Yeah. All right. Goodbye, shopping cart. Goodbye, dresser. Oh. Whew. It's about 1:45 in the afternoon. And because of my refusal to walk on the cold, windy beach, I ended up walking the whole perimeter of this town, basically, to get back here to the 101. Well, there's no hiking on the 101 freeway right here. I may have to go back and hitchhike out of here. Off the exit ramp. I'm gonna go. I was on this path here, but it pretty much ended. There's an overpass over there with not much traffic on it, so I'm probably gonna hit this path back that way and hitchhike out of here. Good news is, the border isn't that far away. I can just get over there. The Oregon Coast Trail northbound begins there. It should be a lot easier hiking. A lot easier to find camps, I guess. You see how easy it is to hitchhike off of this exit. Huh? I'll show you where it is. So, I walked all the way from that overpass down this exit. You see this truck coming, pulling a trailer. And the sign said no pedestrians on the freeway. And I've gotten a ticket for it before on 101 down in Santa Rosa. I want to do that again. I sure don't. Well, here I am. This is the spot. I was throwing the thumb out instead of messing around, but I'll show you the sign. It's probably backwards, but that's it. Yeah, I'm over here. It's kind of hard to catch them off these things. I mean, I've gotten them rides right away, but I've spent the longest amount of time hitchhiking off these things. Not easy. Alright, well, I'm gonna get to it. Kind of weird if you're holding the phone. I didn't take too long. Caught up out of there about 10 minutes after I shut the camera off. Now I'm here in Smith Creek, or Smith River, excuse me. on the other side of this bridge. Anyways, pretty good old dude. Picked me up and gave me a ride here. It's only about 8 miles. He did say some freaky shit at the end of the ride, which I won't repeat. Something to the effect he's gonna go see a friend of his and do unspeakable acts on him. Never know who you're gonna run into.
Never know.
Earlier, I passed a lady. She wasn't happy at all. She wanted somebody to put her out of her misery. I didn't say anything, I just kept walking. You know, people have a bad day. I was on that little trail heading back over to the exit. I saw a guy in a hammock about 20 feet up in a tree. He used a couple pallets to climb up in the hammock. I didn't film it because I saw him go in there, or else I wouldn't even probably look in that direction. Hiking for hours. I almost thought this was the California-Oregon border, but it's not. I don't think. But it's got to be close. It's about 6 o'clock right now. 6 o'clock p.m. in the evening. I've been walking since 9. I got private property on both sides of me walking down this highway. So I didn't really get a chance to rest. We walked through an Indian res. I think I still am. I'm not sure the name. I'm not gonna attempt to say it, but it's the one right near the Oregon border in California. So hopefully I get out of this state while it's still daylight and I can find a place to camp. Like I said, being surrounded on both sides of the street with private property is making it difficult to even rest. Welcome to Oregon. It is now 6:13, so yeah, man. I kind of was at the Oregon border. Oh, what a relief. Found a little cubby hole off the beach. Got a little sun for the solar power. It's not huge. Big enough to have dinner. Which is what I'm about to do. Let's have some Mexican rice and pasta blend with bell peppers and Mexican seasoning. Oh, that sounds so good right now. And while I'm cooking that, I'm going to go ahead and give this thing a charge. So,
see at dinner time.
Okay, so I was at 62%. Now I'm at 60. So it's not really acting right. Luckily I've got another power source on it. Charge the phone till I get the kinks worked out in that. Meanwhile, rice is done, I believe. Let's see how it is. Hot sauce. That's good. I still haven't decided if I'm gonna stay here or not. If I do, I have to be just sitting on top of a tarp. I don't really have enough room to set up a shelter. Ground's not that even either. Probably lay in here. If I decide to stay here, I would lay right here where I cooked. Most of the wind. All right, I'm gonna woof this down. That was absolutely wonderful. I did get up from that spot and move on. Over here at the visitor center, seeing if they got restrooms. Be really cool.
They did.
They do. So, I'm definitely finding a camp around here somewhere. This is the ultimate place. To have a restroom in the morning and a picnic table. There's a picnic table right here. Check it out. Grizzly Field Visitor Center, that's what this is. Sure where the restrooms are. We'll find out. Let's see what's going on in here. Looks closed to me. Yet it's open. Still a little water too, huh? All right. Okay. Looks like we're about to have a beautiful sunset. Sky's clear, but I don't have a place to camp yet. This place closes, I believe, at 9. Guessing that there'll be a park ranger along to close it up and run everybody out of here. So I'm going to have to find a place to duck in. Seems like there would be a lot of places, right?
Looks that way.
Let me go investigate. Let's go. Walking the trail to the beach. Sunset is hiller. Huh. Looks like some spots over there, maybe. Check this out over here. I just came down this trail from the visitor center. That's it up there. That's the roof. So I got a clearing in here. There is some still water that way, so if I was to stay in here, there'd probably be a few mosquitoes. Lots of places in there. Probably if somebody comes and checks at night. Wait for this place to close. Come back in here. Wow. Okay. Okay. I don't see any sign of anybody else camping here, which is a good thing. I have to come back here and see a bunch of garbage like I do at the homeless camps. Let's just see what this goes. Still have plenty of light to find the perfect spot. I like to have a nice spot in here where I can just go sit on the beach, watch the sunset, and then set camp. Sunset that way. Looks like the mouth to a river. Now where we're at. Lots of places here. I think we're good here. Spot, huh? I'm gonna call this spot home for the night. There's shelter over there in the water. So check it out. Yeah, so the tide definitely affects the mouth of the river. For sure. Alright, this shelter over here. You're going underwater. Must be high tide. There you go, mud shelter. I'm gonna post up over here on one of these logs. Watch the sunset.
That's nice.
Not sure the name of this river. Gorgeous though. There's some logs over here and a post right over here. Sunset doesn't look as cool, and I got the camera in reverse.
All right, I'm gonna watch the sunset, snap some pics.
Is that the camera? Is that one? Am I looking right at you?
All right.
Well, the sun went down, so I guess I better get to it. Let's go find a spot. I think I came in from there. Let's see what's over here. Haven't seen anybody. There's some people across the river. But they got houses over there. Probably what it is. I know it's over here. I'll probably go back to the other spot. Can't wait to clean this sand out of my shoes. It's pretty dark in there. I hope this shows up okay. Well, there's bike tracks, foot tracks. Looks like they stay on the trail. All right, I'm liking this. I think I like this. I just came through here. That's the only way in, it looks like. Missing piece of moss.
Well, what do you think?
I like it too.
All right, let's get set up. So I've sat here until it's pitch black. I haven't heard any footsteps. I haven't heard any voices. And those are the two things I don't want to hear right now. So I'm going to go on in and pull out my sleeping bag now. I don't like being packed just in case somebody comes. But I think it's safe to go on and pull that sleeping bag out. It's turning out to be a pretty good spot. All right, let me crawl in there. Okay, so I am tucked away in my little tent here. My sleeping bag. Sure which way I'm gonna lay my head. Guess I'm gonna lay my head right here in the front. Night, you guys. See you in the morning for coffee.